We know the Amazon rainforest is a pivotal part of Earth's ecosystem, and losing it will be devastating to the planet. We've already lost 20%, and scientists warn that the rainforest is coming uncomfortably close to a tipping point, where an irreversible change in the climate system could transform this luscious landscape into a dry, savanna-like ecosystem, which would be huge. The Amazon basin spans over 6 million square kilometers and is home to 1/5 of the world's land species. It also supports the 30 million people who live and depend on the land as a source of food, medicine, and shelter. That's not even including the key role it plays in regulating the regional and global climate. Trees absorb water through their roots and transport it to their leaves, where it's released as water vapor through small pores in a process called transpiration. As the water vapor rises and condenses, it forms rain clouds over the forest canopy. Basically, the rainforest is making its own weather. For example, one large tree can release 1,000 liters of water into the atmosphere in a single day. The rainforest recycles this water up to 6 times before it moves out of the region. But as more trees are cut down, those that remain may not be able to recycle enough water to survive. Fewer trees means more sunlight will hit the forest floor, exposing the forest to higher temperatures. Since deforestation began accelerating in the 1970s, 800,000 square kilometers of the Amazon have been lost. And over that same period, the average temperature of the basin has risen by 1 degree Celsius. Scientists are concerned that if deforestation continues for another 10 to 15 years, the eastern and southern Amazon will turn into a savanna. Not only would losing the rainforest mean a drastic change in this weather system, but remember, the Amazon is also a well-known and excellent carbon sink. This means that its trees suck carbon dioxide right out of the air and store it in their biomass through photosynthesis. An estimated 136 to 181 billion metric tons of carbon are stored this way, helping to slow the rate of global warming. But scientists have found evidence that the Amazon could flip from being a carbon sink to a carbon source if unchecked deforestation continues. Some estimates show that this is already happening in 1/5 of the Amazon, and yet deforestation continues. Between August 2018 and July 2019, tree loss has increased to more than 10,000 square kilometers, the largest rate in roughly a decade. With scaled back environmental protections in the region, commercial operations like farming and logging are expected to continue growing the rate of deforestation. At present, fires are typically set to clear the land for these practices. In fact, an estimated 90% of the Amazon fires in 2019 were intentionally set, releasing roughly 392 million metric tons of CO2 into the air. And in just the first 8 months of 2020, fires added around 226 million metric tons of carbon dioxide into the air, the equivalent of nearly 50 million cars. This is where the scientists' forecast comes in. According to their study, if deforestation reaches 20 to 25% of the Amazon, it will flip to a dry savanna. The reality check is that we're almost there. Current deforestation is at a frightening 17% across the entire Amazon basin and approaching 20% in the Brazilian Amazon. So at this point, you're probably wondering, we're at our limits and what can even be done? Well, don't lose hope. Last September, a motivated group of scientists formed the Science Panel for the Amazon. Their plan is to produce a scientific assessment by 2021 to propose solutions to help secure the forest's future. There are also ambitious reforestation projects in areas like abandoned cattle ranches. These reforested areas make up about 23% of destroyed forests and can absorb carbon 11 times faster than the trees that once stood there. So there is a glimmer of hope. And remember, unlike the 2019 to 2020 forest fires in Australia and California that were fueled by climate change, more than 90% of fires in the Amazon were set by people, which means that we actually have the power to stop them. By changing our behaviors, we can tip the scale in our favor and avoid the savanna-like conditions that scientists say are quickly approaching. But that's just a projection. It won't become a reality unless we let it. The climate crisis is here, and we're here to cover it. Let us know what other stories you'd like to learn more about down in the comments. Subscribe to Seeker to stay informed, and as always, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.